Let's work through the following problem together. Let R be the region bounded by y equals x and y equals x squared between x equals 0 and x equals 1. Compute the volume of the solid generated when this region is rotated around the line y equals 2. So I'm going to start by sketching a picture of my region and also this axis of rotation. So first I have my line y equals x. And then I also have the parabola y equals x squared. So here is my region R. And in this case, I'm actually not rotating this around one of the axes, but I'm rotating it around a different line. And I'm actually rotating it around the line y equals 2. So how are we going to find the volume of the solid in this case? Well, we're actually going to use the washer method, and it's going to be very similar to the case in which we might be rotating this region around the x-axis, which is some slight differences. So let me go ahead and write down a formula that we're going to use, and then we'll see why that formula makes sense to use in this case. Okay, so the volume here is going to be given by integral as usual. Pi times, and there are several different ways you might see this written. I typically write it as R of x squared minus, or capital R of x squared minus little r of x squared dx, where the capital R of x, we're going to say, represents the outer radius of a washer, one of our washers, and little r of x represents the inner radius of one of the washers. And we'll see how to actually compute those radii in just a second. But anyway, why does it make sense to use a washer method in this case? Well, we're rotating around a horizontal line. Right? This y equals 2 is a horizontal line. And in that sense, it is similar to the x-axis. It's just shifted, right? The x-axis is the line y equals 0. This is the line y equals 2. So then, if I want to use the washer method, I'm going to be integrating with respect to x, just like I would if I were revolving around the x-axis. So in our region R, let's draw some little rectangles here. And these rectangles, you can think of rotating these rectangles around this line y equals 2. And think about what shape is going to be formed when you do that. Well, we're going to have this washer shape, right? A circular disc with a hole in the middle. And so basically, when we rotate this region as a whole, we're going to have a series of those washers. So it's just like the washer method from before. We're just going around a different axis of rotation. So then let's apply this formula that I wrote up here, and let's think about the outer radius of the washer, how we would write that, and then also the inner radius of the washer. And we'll write those out individually before we put them in the integral. So the outer radius of the washer, what's that going to be? Well, the outer radius of the washer is going to be the distance between the outer function and the axis of rotation. And when I say the outer function, I just mean the function that's farther away from the axis of rotation. So if I were to sketch in that distance, I'm talking about this distance here. Right, this distance is going to be the outer radius of some washer, capital R of x. So how do we represent that distance? Well, probably the best way to think about it is just think about the top minus the bottom of that line. Well, the top of the line is given by y equals 2. And the bottom of the line is given by this function, y equals x squared. Right? This is y equals x squared here. So then this outer radius of the washer is going to simply be 2 minus x squared. And then we can use the same logic to write down the inner radius of the washer. So the inner radius is simply going to be the distance between the axis of rotation and the function that's closer to it, or the inner function. So this distance here, I will call little r of x. And we use the same idea to write down an expression from that. We can think about it as top function minus bottom function. So that distance r of x, the top of it is given by this line y equals 2, so 2 minus, and the bottom is given by this line y equals x, so minus x. So when you're doing this, just make sure you're consistent. It can get a little confusing about y's versus x's. Just make sure you're consistent when you're writing these formulas. So for example, all my formulas here are y equals something, right? Y equals something. So then when I think top minus bottom, right, I do y equals 2 minus y equals x, for example. So it becomes 2 minus x. And in this case, I am integrating with respect to x because I'm going around a horizontal line. So then from here, we would just plug this in to our function. To our integral. We've got this pi out front, and I'll plug in my bounds in just a second. But I have r of x, and that whole quantity is squared, minus little r of x, whole quantity squared, with respect to x. And then I need to think about my bounds, and those bounds are going to be the bounds of your region R. Okay, so here my region R goes from x equals 0 to x equals 1, right? These should be x values since we're integrating with respect to x. And then I just have to compute this integral. And in this case, actually, I'm going to stop here, right, because setting up the integral is a challenging part. To actually compute the value here, you would simply start by expanding what's inside the integral, so FOILing everything out, and then you can find your antiderivative and plug in your values. In this example, we're told to let R be the region bounded by y equals natural log of x and the y-axis between y equals 0 and y equals 4. And then to compute the volume of the solid created when R is revolved around the line x equals negative 2. So let me start with a sketch of our region R. So here I have the function y equals natural log of x, and then the y-axis between y equals 0 and y equals 4. That's my region R. Now in this case, instead of revolving this region around what we did before, which was actually the y-axis, we're revolving it around the line x equals negative 2. So this line right here. So how are we going to approach this problem? Well, this is really a washer method type of problem. We can think about it this way. When we rotate this region R around this vertical line x equals negative 2, we can think of little horizontal rectangular slices of this region R. And when we think about revolving each of those slices around this line x equals negative 2, then what we're doing when we do that is we're creating these washer shapes. Shapes that look like this. And what we need to do is just compute the surface area of each of those washers, or actually the volume, but the surface area is really what we're interested in formula-wise. So what is our volume formula going to look like in this case? Well, it's going to look similar to the washer method from before. I've got some integral with a pi out front, and I'm going to write it like this. Capital R of y squared minus little r of y squared dy, where capital R of y represents the outer radius of a washer, and little r of y represents the inner radius of a washer, just like it did before. Now, in this case, we're going to be integrating with respect to y, because we're revolving around a vertical line, right? When we revolve around the y-axis, which is a vertical line, we integrate with respect to y. And this is going to be the same scenario. So then what we need to do is we need to compute or write down expressions for capital R of y and little r of y. And actually, before we do that, there's one small additional step we need to take. We're going to want everything to be in terms of y in our function. So that means in my curves here that I have, I'd like everything to be in the form x equals some function of y. So this y equals natural log of x. Let's just rewrite that. Right, I can do an e on both sides and write this as x equals e to the y. So we're just going to do that instead. X equals e to the y. And then also we can go ahead and note that the y-axis can be described by the equation x equals 0. So now we have all our boundaries in terms of x equals some function of y. Okay, so let's start writing down the outer radius of the washer. So visually, how can we understand this outer radius? So the outer radius of the washer is just going to be the distance between the axis of rotation and the function that's farthest away from it, or the outer function. So if I were to draw that in on my graph, that distance, that would be this distance here. So the distance between the axis of rotation and the function that's farther away from it, right, which in this case is this right boundary of my region R, which is given by the curve x equals e to the y. So this here is R of y. Now, how do we describe that formula-wise or algebraically? Well, we can think of it as right minus left is probably the best way to do it. So if I look at my distance here, R of y on my graph, the right-hand boundary of that distance is given by x equals e to the y. So right minus, and then on the left I have x equals negative 2, so minus negative 2, or e to the y plus 2. And then we can use the same idea to figure out our inner radius, little r of y. So the inner radius then should be the distance between the axis of rotation and the closer boundary or the closer function. Now in my case, the left-hand boundary of my region, right, is just formed by the y-axis right here. Right, that's the closer function in my case. Okay, so once again, I can think about right minus left. So if I look at my little r of y line that I drew here, the right-hand side of this line is given by the line x equals 0. And the left-hand end of this line is given by the line x equals negative 2. So I have 0 minus negative 2. Or just 2, which makes sense, right? This inner radius is just the distance between the lines x equals 0 and x equals negative 2, which should be a distance of 2. Okay, so now I can start plugging in into my integral. We'll leave the bounds for a second. We need to square R of y, capital R of y. So e of y plus 2 quantity squared minus little r of y squared, so minus 4. And I'm integrating with respect to y. And then finally, I want to think about my bounds. Now, these are going to be the bounds of my region R. And they need to be y values in this case, since I'm integrating with respect to y. So I'm told explicitly that my region goes between y equals 0 and y equals 4. So those are going to be the bounds here. And we're not going to actually work out the integral in this case, because I'm pretty confident that you guys can do that on your own. The new part here is setting this up. Right? If you wanted to compute it, you would FOIL this e to the y plus 2 squared, and then take the antiderivative and go from there.